Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the first video of my new channel, Vintage Vocals. Quite excited about this. I'm hoping that it will actually work out. Where we're going to be taking a look at classic old musical films and some of the songs from those films. Today we'll be talking about the movie musical Grease, hence the slightly 50s updo, and specifically the song sung by the character Sandy out on her front porch, Hopelessly Devoted to You. But before then, let's take a look at the movie.
In 1978, one of Broadway's most beloved shows was adapted for film. The movie Grease is well known for its comedy, romance, and teenage drama, as well as spectacular dance scenes and musical numbers. Grease was a huge hit and became the highest-grossing musical film ever made. The movie centers around two high school sweethearts whose love affair takes a turn as they both realize they have two very different reputations and must make big compromises if they are to stay together. The movie starred 23-year-old John Travolta, who had just gotten his big break with the movie Saturday Night Fever, and 29-year-old Olivia Newton John, who had already established herself as a Grammy-winning pop and country singer. Having played in the Broadway production of Grease, John Travolta, who was familiar and a bit of a fan of Olivia Newton John's, thought she would be the best pick for this character of Sandy. Though Olivia would not agree to do the film without a screen test to make sure she seemed okay as a character, she eventually starred in the role and her fame as well as John Travolta's skyrocketed. An interesting fact about the movie, the song Hopelessly Devoted to You, which we will be taking a look at, wasn't recorded or filmed until the rest of the movie was finished. Even still, the song was nominated for an Oscar as Best Original Song.
Now that we've looked a little at the movie, let's get to the song Hopelessly Devoted to You. This song is beautiful. I love it. Olivia Newton-John is legit my hero. Her songs are so inspiring to me, and her whole career and everything. She's definitely an inspiration for me. But anyways, this song is very musical theater in style. And because musical theater is a mix of acting and singing, there are some basic theater building blocks that you can apply to your song, which will allow you to get a richer, fuller perspective of the character as well as the piece you're singing. Tip number one, you should look at the emotion of the song. What is it? Can you identify it? And how does that emotion grow or change within the course of the song? Tip number two, who or what is the song about? And what is the character's relationship to that thing? Number three, what is the objective? This means, what is the character trying to get or do in the song? Number four, what happened before this scene that brought the character up to the point of singing this song? Once you have that backwork in place, you can now jump into the actual vocals of the song, which I am going to play it, start it and pause it where I want, and hopefully this works. We'll give this a shot. Okay, so beautiful song, right? So what I can observe, the vocals in the first few lines are very emotional and soft. From what I can tell, the dominant emotions seem to be sadness, a bit of confusion. What jumps out to me the most, though, is this sort of sense of insecurity, which the character definitely brings out when she sings. It's not strong or confident. It's very gentle. You'll observe very breathy, almost a whisper, because it's just so soft that it's almost whisper-like singing. What the character is doing is using what we call a head voice. Now in singing, there are two major voices which are used, these being your chest voice and your head voice. You use your chest voice by tensing up the muscles in your stomach and pushing strongly to get the air over top of your vocal cords. This will achieve a very loud sound. You use your head voice also by keeping the muscles in your stomach tight, but you don't push nearly as hard. I like to think of it like easing on and off a car accelerator. The harder you push, the more intense you'll drive. Similarly in singing, the harder you push, the louder the sound. Now for this first section, it seems to me the higher the notes go, the more breathy they become. My eyes are not the first to cry. So instead of going, my eyes are not the first to cry, my eyes are not the first to cry. All right, I have cue cards. I have this little thing I wrote up, hence I'm constantly looking down because I can't remember what I wrote. Okay, so we're gonna go on with the song. You hear that really quite breathy sound, right? So, observation number two, when she comes to that line do, as well as you, I just noticed that with you, she actually drops three notes at once. They're very quick, you, do, and now I'm pretty sure these notes are E, D, and A, and don't quote me on this. I can't really show you how to do this entirely. I've kind of learned to do it. I'm not proficient at it, but I've kind of learned to do it by definitely doing a head voice. And you can imagine like you're wearing socks and you're on a staircase and you drop down three separate stairs, but you're going so fast that it's almost like they're connected. So I'll try and example it. Do, ooh, ooh. Those are the three notes. Do, ooh. Ooh, but instead of separating them, you connect them. Do, do, I'm hopelessly devoted to you. I don't know. Something like that. Okay, so now we're moving on to the chorus. Let's play it again.
I'm hopelessly devoted to you.
So good. So there is an immediate emotional build as well as a vocal change. The quiet, heady, breathy voice switches out to way more confident chest voice as the character shouts out, but now, but now. So you can achieve that by again tensing those stomach muscles and pushing the air out. Make sure to drop your jaw, but now, instead of now, now, drop your jaw. So the confident chest voice, there's that coordinating conjunction, grammar nerd moment here, but the coordinating conjunction of but now used to connect and contrast the original sentiment of that self-pity and the hopelessness with a sudden confident statement of devotion shown so well masterfully through the vocals. Okay, so hopelessly devoted. Devoted. Man, I can't talk today. Devoted. So those hopelessly devoted notes need to be very strong and powerful. So stand up tall. allowing for your lungs to fully expand. And on devoted, for an ideal mouth position where it's easier to belt out the note, instead of saying the vowel E in ed, like devoted to you, change the ed to an A, devoted, which you can see, I'll demonstrate both, devoted to you, devoted to you. You open your jaw more and it allows more of that air to come out, and it's way easier to belt going A instead of E. So try going devoted to you. From here on, the song is a mix of head voice and chest voice. You will notice instead of individual singular notes, she combines them together like they are attached on a string, moving like on a wave. And I'll try and show you an example here. I'm gonna play it again. Oh, we're still hopelessly about it. Right there. I don't know what she's doing. I just hear it. So there's a few things that you can try and do. Number one, I'd say try and do what I do. I am a completely non-technical singer. I hear it. And to me, music is emotion. So it's just like kind of connecting to it and feeling where the song goes. Song leads me, not the other way around. Second thing you can do if you're a more technical person is go to a piano, slow that voice right down and try and find the notes and separate them individually. Again, that's the jumping from notes to notes very quickly. Easy to do that by using your head voice, and imagine your throat. When I do it, I kind of imagine like I'm writing a scribbly line. I don't know why I see that in my head. I just do. It's like there's the note and I'm going up and around that note, just hitting all the notes in like a scale that would fit that note, so that it's not off key or anything. But because it's all in the same scale, you can jump up or jump down and then originally return to the original note. That makes sense. Find your own way. I'm not a professional, so I don't actually know how to teach this professionally, but that's what I do. Now we're going to be moving on to the last note, which I'm going to play here. So, last note. Unless you are a soprano, most people are going to find that note pretty high. Olivia Newton John had an amazing vocal range and could hit pretty low alto notes as well as really high soprano notes. And so hopefully I can give you a few tips on how to hit that note. The note is for sure sung with your head voice and it's quite soft. A tip my old singing instructor taught me for hitting notes that are very high is to firstly stand very tall and like completely tall, like give your posture like a full once over, look down at your feet, look at your shoulder line and where your jaw is. Don't tilt your jaw up. That's a big major mistake. It completely cuts off the air here and it's actually very, very hard on your throat. Also, don't tense up your shoulders. Just keep your posture straight, allowing for the air to fill up and allowing for you to get the most out of it. And what he told me to do is to tense up the stomach muscles, but more importantly, it's a little embarrassing, you tense up the muscles in the back. If you get my meaning back there, awkwardness, but it actually does help you get the note, as strange as it is. And also for that high note, don't think about reaching up the scale to grab it. Imagine you already have it. It's already within your grasp, and it's in front of you. I'm a very visual learner, so I have to see everything in front of me to actually grasp how to do it. I don't know if that works for you. But just imagine you already have that note and you're simply trying to, this is the note and this is the air coming up over top of it. So it's almost like, I mean, you can use vibrato if it's easier for you to hit that note. For me, that's easier to hit that note. But that's actually not the way the characters sing it. It's definitely breathy and heady and not strong. And I think that's about it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope it was helpful to you. And enjoy those summer nights out on your front porch singing Hopelessly Devoted to You. Just make sure the neighbors aren't around. Bye for now. Vintage Vocals, where we take a look at iconic. Vintage Vocals, where we took a look. I can't believe this. Where we're going to. And looking. I can't believe this. I can't. Vintage Vocals, where. Once that backward is placed. Now, first.